Pastels. Peggy Jester has a wonderful example of everything that she's interested in right here in her own working studio. Peggy, thank you so much for letting us come today.
My treat.
Well, we appreciate looking at all the different avenues and what you've liked to do. What did you start out? Not in printmaking. What was your first love?
First love was pottery.
Okay.
Making little cups and pitchers and planters. Did that at the art center about 5-6 years, and then our children were in school, and I thought I would like to learn how to paint. I do not have any experience with that, so I went to got admitted to the master program at Drake, and 5 years later I had a degree.
Did you start out with pastels, watercolors, acrylics? What?
Pretty much. A media that you can change a lot and to perfect over a period of time. Mm-hmm. Oil and acrylic is good on that, and that's canvas. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you can do it on paper too. But.
And what attracted you, like landscapes, flowers, portraits?
We had a garden that just was so great, and I love gardening. I love fresh food, and this was a big food garden. Mm-hmm. And I just got so acquainted with everything in a garden, bugs, snakes, rabbits, and everything that grew, and its organic shapes and how the light affected the whole thing. Anyway, I loved the gardens.
Then you moved on to printmaking, and tell mm-hmm. us about that. You bought your own printmaking.
I did buy a press. I took a little bit of printmaking. Most recently at the Art Center, the last few years, I've taken it as a night class there. Mm-hmm. And but the printmaking technique I like the best is monotype, where you can put down a shape and then run it through the press and then say, oh, I think I'll have a little different shape here or color, and put that in and run it through the press again. So some of these over here are built up that way.
Several layers?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Several ideas, but not all at once. Do it once and see what it needs and run it again through with another idea on top or a shape or a color.
Now tell me about the botanical prints that you have been doing. That's a whole series for you.
Oh, yeah. About 5 years ago, I started picking up weeds with the idea that if there were color behind them or involved, that they would be beautiful. Mm-hmm. And I remember as a young girl, Girl Scouts, we used to press flowers in our dictionary, and they were so pretty. And it's always, every plant has a name, and it's fun to learn their names, and you can combine them on a picture and glue them down. Anyway, this technique is called a monotype. They are a print, but there's only one of them. And after the ink is used up and the plant's all smashed in the press, there's nothing more to print.
Interesting.
So you go out and get more weeds, more and do it a different color or background.
They're fascinating. They're beautiful. And now you're on to abstract. Where is this coming from?
I'm trying to find a way to make it a lot of fun and not just to do something and say, what else does it need? Mm-hmm. What else will make it alive? Hmm. And is it another color, another shape? That's mm-hmm. where I'm gonna go next.
And are you still teaching? You were doing several?
No. Okay. I taught for about 10 years at the Art Center. Mm-hmm. And it's been about a good 5 years since I stopped teaching there. I loved it doing it. Mm-hmm.
Well, obviously, it's taken you many different routes.
Yes.
And so next time I see some weeds, I'll think of you, Peggy.
Okay.
Okay, I appreciate it.
Just don't bring them over and throw them in the yard.
No, okay, no, won't do that. All right, thank you, Peggy, for letting us stop by today. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'm Molly Cooney, KCCI-TV, in the Artist Studio. For more on Peggy's...